You're watching S-StarTV, I'm DJ DUBL. Today I'm here with Benny Banks. What's good, brother?
We're about to open up for Matt Miller, still.
That's it, man. So last year you got signed to the major, congratulations. And since then, there's been a lot of hype around your name. So, but the thing what I want to know is, how did you get into music in the first place? What started you spitting?
Just being bored in my house, man. Yeah, man. Just started doing it, man. I don't know how to answer that. Just come naturally.
So what kind of music, when you're not recording, when you're not writing, what do you listen to?
Everything, yeah. All sorts of music, like most genres, really. Apart from opera, I'm kind of good at everything.
Cool, man. So I want you to talk me through the day you got signed. From when you woke up to when you got the phone call, what happened?
Me and Z got up, went cafe, and we went to the office and signed it, you know, that was kind of straightforward. Yeah, there weren't really no complications around it or nothing, it was just easy 10 minutes.
So when you found out, like, talk me through the moment you actually found out that you was getting signed. It must have been a good feeling, huh?
It was exciting, like a new beginning, innit? That's something to look forward to, innit? A different way of life, I guess. So I'm enjoying it, something new.
See it coming, really, or is it unexpected?
A bit of both, man. Hard work pays off, I guess.
Most definitely. So obviously, as I said, you're signed to 679. Same label as The Streets, Plan B, two major artists. The first single out now, obviously, Bada Boom. That's kind of like the breakthrough thing, the one that everybody's singing right now. But that tune's a lot different to your older stuff. Tunes like My Past, things like that. So how did you get inspired to do two Bada Boom?
Sean P just gave me the beat. I don't know, it's not really inspired to do it. I just make music, man. It's not like, I don't wake up and think of what kind of music I want to make, I just go with it. Luckily it's going well, so I just appreciate it while it lasts.
Did The Sopranos have anything to do with the name of the tune?
Oh no, I don't even watch The Sopranos, you know.
You know what I'm asking you that though, right?
Say it, everyone told me about it. Yeah, I've never actually seen it, so I can't vouch it, but yeah, man, nothing to do with The Sopranos.
So if anyone that doesn't know, Bada Bing is the name of the strip club in The Sopranos. Exactly. So that's why I asked. So I've heard some of your fans comment and they're worried that now you're signed to the major's going to start directing your music and it might come from a different angle. And you know, like, I mean, Chipmunk had it back in the day. People were kind of complaining, saying he was selling out. Is that something that you're worried about, or creatively?
I told it myself, man. I can put out music that I'm comfortable with all the time.
Cool, man. So when it comes to your music, what's your favourite style? Is it the more deep tunes like My Past, or the more club upbeat things that get people bouncing like Bada Bing?
In the middle, like, I like both of them. Depends on the day of the week, sadly, innit, or what the mood is. But, honestly, I just like honest music. I like real music, man.
Talking of honest music, obviously, like, I've noticed from your lyrics, you don't really talk about guns and jewellery and cars and all that kind of thing. It's real, if you know what I mean.
I don't really live like that, man. So I can't really go into it too much, you know, them ones. But obviously I respect people that live in that way. That's why I listen to them talk about it.
So you still rate the music, people like who are you rating?
Too much names, obviously. The Man Them, Joey, Squeaks, Props, Million. There's a load of rappers, but at the minute I'm just focusing on myself. Like, I'm not really listening to everyone else's music. I'm just trying to master my art.
I rate that, man. So, as you said, you're supporting Mac Miller on tour. That's a good look. First date tonight, obviously. So,
always the worst, but.
And already there's a massive queue outside. So that's a good look.
He's looking big. We can get a little shot out the window in a second, see it. But it's very, very, it's way down the road.
That's it. There it is, right there. So Mac Miller, obviously, are you looking to collaborate together?
Got a chat. Already one of these songs I dropped out a remix for him, but I can't let off the name just yet. So,
right. So you already done it.
Should be out next week though.
Okay, cool. So you heard that here first. Apart from Mac Miller, you done things with The Streets, obviously, label mates. You done Dappy as well.
Yeah, obviously tunes with Blacks and everyone, tunes with Hitman. Working with a few people, but I don't really want to let off everything that no one knows about anymore. All the surprises, I stay surprises.
All right, do me one favor. Give me one secret. One person that no one else knows that you're collaborating with.
One secret. I don't know. I can't, because then if you know, it's on YouTube and then everyone will know, so it won't be a secret. Who didn't I say? Mav, because people know about that. I've got something with Maverick say about it as well.
Other than the remix, because you did the remix with him, right? For him.
We tried something else, more slowed down and that, yeah.
That's another exclusive right there. So, something I love asking artists, I love hearing the answer to, is what I call the ultimate collaboration. Dead or alive, any artist ever, who would you most like to work with?
Seal. Yeah.
Wow, I didn't expect that one, you know. Is that the first time you heard that? Wow, Seal. Okay, why Seal?
Because Batman used to gas me up, and at the end, a new song used to come on, so I just remembered Seal. And he looks like he's been through the wars, so he's a real love singer, man. Yeah. Got the scars to prove it, he's going hard.
I rate that, man. And has it got anything else to do with his fan base being mostly females, and maybe that might have something to do with it?
Now that you say it, it could be, but I didn't even know. I didn't even know his fan base was that big, man. I was just gassed off Batman. But yeah, man.
No, I like that, man. I like it. It was unexpected, definitely. So, obviously, you're doing the UK dates with Mac Miller. You've got Manchester tomorrow. Bristol and Birmingham, I think, are on there as well.
Sunday, so yeah, boy.
Cool. So after that, what's the plan?
I'm coming back to drop one of my singles. Sorry, my phone is turned off. I'm dropping a single, and then that's the one with Dappy. And then from there, just gonna keep it going, see what happens.
Keeping the studio work heavy?
Yeah. It's going every day.
Cool, man. So obviously, all the fans already know, but what about the future fans? Have you got a website, Twitter that they can hit you up on?
Mr. Benny Banks. On Twitter, that's MRBENNY Banks. You must be able to spell Banks. Facebook's Mr. Benny Banks, I think. My website's BennyBanks.com. Just Google it. Benny Banks. It's all there on the internet and iTunes.
That's it. It's all there. So it's S-StarTV, DJ DUBL. I'm in a place with Benny Banks. He's one to watch. So keep your eyes peeled. City bitch, rack city bitch, rack city bitch, rack city bitch, rack city bitch,
rack city with a bit of bada bing in it. Come on, man. Should we scrock it out?
Basically, what it is, right? Stay off me. Say no to drugs. And don't speak to strangers. And don't talk with your mouth full.
What's up with all the evils?